Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will be showcasing how to customize the radial bar series in the .NET MAUI circular chart. I'll demonstrate how to adjust the size of the radial bar, inner circle, and manage the gap between each segment. I'll show you how to customize the stroke color and width of the filled radial bar, and the appearance of the bar track. Additionally, I'll show you how to add an image within the radial bar and customize the colors of its segments. Here, I am using an example application that has been pre-configured with the MAUI chart's namespace and the MAUI circular chart control. The circular chart control includes the radial bar series along with data. In a radial bar series, segments are arranged in a circular pattern to show data categories and their values. If you want to know how to create a MAUI app and configure MAUI circular chart, check the Getting Started video linked in the YouTube card. Also, you can download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description. Now, I'll launch the application on an Android emulator. Once it is loaded, you can see the radial bar displayed and filled with a default color that corresponds to the value. Now, let me show you how to change the size and inner radius of a radial bar. The default value of a radial bar is 0.8, which represents 80% of the available size, with the inner radius of 0.4, which represents 40%. To modify the size, set the radius property to 1. To adjust the inner circle size, set the inner radius property to 0.2. As you can see, the size and inner radius are changed. Now, let's move on to adjusting the gap between each segment of the radial bars and the span of the segment-filled area in the radial bar track. By default, the gap ratio is set to 0.2. To increase the gap, add the gap ratio property and set its value to 0.4. Here, the default value of the maximum value property is double nan. This represents the highest possible value that can be displayed in the radial bar track. In this demonstration, I will set the maximum value to 100. Check here, you will notice a corresponding change in the filled tracks, with an increased gap between each segment. Next, moving on to the cap style of the radial bar segments, cap style supports four options: both flat, both curve, start curve, and end curve. By default, it is set to both flat. To change the cap style, set the cap style property to both curve. As you can see, both the start and end segments of the radial bar are now curved. Now, let me demonstrate how to change the stroke color and stroke width to the filled area in the radial bar segments. By default, the stroke color is null, meaning no stroke color is applied. The stroke property can be set to the desired color, such as brown. Additionally, the default value of the stroke width is 2. To increase its value, set the stroke width property to 4. Once the chart is loaded, you will see that the stroke color has changed to brown and the stroke width to 4. Next, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the track in the radial bar chart. By default, the track stroke width property is set to 1. To change it, I set the track stroke width property to 4. Furthermore, the default values for the track stroke and fill colors are null. To modify the track's appearance, I set the track stroke color property to red. Similarly, set the track fill color property to yellow. Once the chart is loaded, you will notice that the track stroke width has been changed to 4, the stroke color to red, and the fill color to yellow. These changes provide a customized appearance to the chart's track area. Next, let me demonstrate how to customize the center view of the radial bar chart, specifically by placing an image in the center. First, I define the center view property for the radial bar series, which allows customization of the center view of the chart. Next, I add a stack layout control inside the center view. Here, I set the center hole size property to width request and height request properties. The center hole size property represents the size of the radial bar's center. Inside the stack layout, add an image control. The image has already been added to the resources folder, therefore set its source property to the appropriate value. Before running the application, make sure to remove the track appearance customization code, as it is not required for this customization. You will notice that the image is placed at the center of the radial bar, providing an enhanced visual representation. Finally, I will show you how to customize the appearance of the segments with custom colors. To do this, go to the View Model class and create a new property named Custom Palette Brushes, which holds a collection of brushes. In the constructor, add the desired colors to the collection. Next, navigate to the main page XAML. Define the palette brushes property in the radial bar series and set its value by binding the custom palette brushes. You will see the segment's colors customized. In this video, you learned how to adjust the size of the radial bar series, modify the inner radius, and manage the gaps between each segment. You also saw how to customize the stroke color and width of the radial bar, as well as how to customize the track appearance, including the stroke color and fill color. Finally, you saw how to add an image within the radial bar and customize segment colors. If you want to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for the entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.